I'm going to show you how to create a reorder list for your products that are compiled on one sheet that will get sourced from numerous sheets. So I've got the reorder list for my product for sheet 3 here. And so if you look, so if our product, if our inventory gets to be less than 5, then they would reorder. So what I have done here is I've put the number, the products that we need to reorder on the reorder sheet. And so let me show you how I've done it. And what we will do is we will reorder for the sheet 2 here. So I'm going to display my filter and I'm going to select all. Okay, so I put a line here so I knew where I was starting. And so let's go here. And what we're going to do is we're going to do an equals if and then we're going to go to sheet 2 and we're going to say if this is greater or less than 5 then you're going to display this product name or the label for this product. And if it's not, then we're going to do a blank. So what we're going to do is we are going to drag this down. So for my second column, I'm going to do very similar. I'm going to go equals if. And then I'm going to go back to my sheet 2 and I'm going to go if this is less than 5 then display that value and if it's not less than 5 display a 0. Okay, but there's one problem here is we need to know what the value is for our next step. So what we're going to do is we're going to put brackets around it. We're going to go value. We don't want to display the formula when we do calculations. We want to have the value of the result displayed there. And so when we drop this down, you can see the values are all displayed. Now, what we need this for is if we we continue on this formula, so if B18 is greater than 0, then we put a 0, then we put a true there. And if it and if it's not, it's false. So let's drag that down. So now to reorder or to get your reorder sheet, what you do is you run this and you just want the ones that are true. So we say, okay. So here you have your reorder parts list. Now this is fine, but sometimes you have parts lists on another sheet. So let's handle that one as well. So now let's display all the values that we have here so we know where to put it in. And so then on this one, what I'm going to do is equals if. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to another sheet that I have here. And my sheet's called parts. And so I say if the serial number is less than 5, then display the serial number, display the serial number. And if it's not, and you display nothing. When you're going to another sheet, you have to be careful because it's not going to allow you to drag down. If you look in our formula here, I have absolute reference on everything. So I would like absolute reference on my column, so the B, and I would like to take the dollar sign off my row number. So I'm going to delete that, and I'm going to delete the row number for there. And we press enter. And then we can drag that down. And so there you have the serial numbers that need to be reordered. Now, similar to the ones above, what you're going to do is go equals and value. And then I'm going to go to my other sheet. And I'm going to go if. And then a bracket, if this, once again, take off the dollar sign for your row number. If this is less than 5, then display this one. Take off your dollar sign on your row number. And if it's not, display 0. Oops. Display 0. Okay, so now what we can do is we can drag this down. And so now we have two different sheets. We drag down our true and false here. Now, to eliminate the zeros, what I did is I selected this column. I went to conditional formatting. And I said highlight cell rules that are equal to. And I said 0. And then what I've done is I custom formatting. And then I chose the font color of blank and the fill as blank. So you don't need to see the zeros. And say OK. So to get our reorder list, what you do is you take the select all off of here, select the true, and say OK. And there you have your reorder list of parts coming from different sheets or different sheets on the one workbook and a different workbook totally. Please subscribe.